All right, so let's get you the latest updates in terms of what is happening in Turkey, where the Turkish parliament, it appears, has passed a controversial bill which will allow the government to regulate social media and content on social media sites. The new law gives the government a greater control over citizens' online activities. Social media giants such as Facebook, Twitter and YouTube will have to open a local office in Turkey. Now, companies that won't comply with the new rules will have to pay fines and also face bandwidth restrictions, which will make the platforms unusable. Now, social media giants will also have to comply with government demands to block and remove content or face a hefty fine. The law also requires firms to store user data locally, sparking fears that the government will use the new rules to crack down on dissent. The critics have said that the legislation will severely impact the freedom of speech in Turkey. President Erdogan has vowed to increase social media monitoring, saying that some social media users trolled Finance Minister Berat Albayrak, who also happens to be his son-in-law. And to give us more perspective in terms of what this controversial law actually means, we are joined in by Onur Erim, who's a political analyst who's joining us live from Istanbul. Now, Mr. Erim, let me begin by asking you this. Now, this is a bill that many people have said will actually cut down on the freedom that many people enjoy when they access these social media websites. How is this law being received in Turkey?
Well, when this law is being criticized in Turkey, when you said many, it's actually many of the opposition of AK Party and the MHP party forming the People's Coalition in Turkey. So it's the opposition that's opposing to this. However, there's also been a criticism towards them, even from the some of the opposition members, as to nobody can see as to exactly what they are criticizing within the law, because the law that was passed is very simple. Mm-hmm. It requires for those social media outlets that have more than 1 million hits per day in Turkey to keep a person, not even an office, a responsible person in Turkey. That's number one. Number two, it's requiring that if there is any requests by the public on their social medias, where the person has been subject to profound language, a personal threat, or things of that nature, that would be regularly be a penalty under the law in the regular life. Right. As opposed to social media life, that they be responsible and correspond within 48 hours. Now, it says correspond. It doesn't mean that they have to do it. It doesn't mean that they have to do what the user wants. It just has to correspond. Now, what used to happen today, because there was absolutely almost no law regulating this, what used to happen if the user had a bad experience, he or she would go to court. A court proceeding as such in Turkey would take about a month at least. And then if the court decides to pass a ruling on the matter, it would send its case to the U.S., which would take another 3-4 months. Now, we're talking about life threats here. We're talking about unfounded accusations. We're talking about profound language used to, whether they are politicians or not, regular people, doesn't matter. There was a problem with the whole way of non-regulatory issues in Turkey.
Now, Mr. Onur, if I could just interrupt you there. I mean, you're using a legal argument. You're saying that if there were to be a threat of life that was made against any individual, if there was strong or profane language that was used, then, you know, the way that you could actually get a redress was by making a complaint to the social media site, and the Turkish law would not apply. Is that what you're suggesting?
No, what used to happen till this law was passed, they would go to Turkish court, get a ruling if the court sees them right, and then that ruling be passed on to the U.S. This whole process, and then it was up to the U.S. Courts and or the company over there, or wherever they are, besides us, but most of them are in the U.S., that process would take 3 to 4 months. What's happening right now is Turkey is saying to these social media outlets, you have to keep somebody responsible here, where people can interact. Now, they don't have to give them a positive feedback. All they have to do is they have to reply within 48 hours. Now, if that case is still not resolved, then you go to courts. And if courts find you right, then the government from now on, under this law, would have somebody responsible to, you know, talk to about court matters. If those court rulings are not satisfied by these companies, then comes in the bans. As of date, the critics of this law are showing, you know, concern about this law could be turned into a stricter ban by the government on freedom of speech.
You know, that actually brings me to the next question, and the most obvious and the logical question that a lot of people would ask once this bill has been passed. Is this an attempt by Recep Tayyip Erdogan to crack down on freedom of speech and expression? Is this an attempt to crack down on people who may want to plan and organize a protest against the government? Because with this new law, the government is now keeping a much closer watch on what people write, share on their social media platforms.
That is actually not true. I mean, the government has had the right to ban and to actually erase social media or any other thing on the internet if the courts were to see that it was against any kind of a law in Turkey. What it is doing right now is, without banning the whole site, it's giving a chance for the company to respond to it. Here's the problem. Yes, the opposition in Turkey is widely, it seems, that they're against this law, saying that this will cause a more of a ban on freedom of speech by the AK Party government. However, and this is actually a criticism right now from within the opposition as well, the law is showing no signs of such behavior. However, also, whether the government and its all of its institutions try to use this law to actually build a non-existent ban on freedom of speech is another matter. I think everybody agrees in Turkey that from all the speeches that I hear, all the conversations that we have to see how this law will be applied, because within the law, there is not a single indicator that could actually prove to anybody that this is an attempt to put a more stricter watch on freedom of speech.
All right, Mr. Erdem, we'll have to leave it there, because this is, of course, going to be a very contentious issue. The government, of course, will go on to defend the law that it has passed. But many critics would, of course, turn around and say that this is just another attempt to try and crack down on dissent and also curtail the freedom of expression in the country.
To those, we should also say that it's definitely not even close to the kind of bans or restrictions that Germany is trying to put, France is trying to put, or US is trying to put. We should also point that out.
All right, Mr. Onur Erdem, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you. Istanbul.